So this is to introduce the central facility BioOptics light microscopy of the Max Perutz labs. So we are working with light. This means we are working with photons, and this is that part of the electromagnetic spectrum which everybody actually uses in everyday life for looking at things. We are in the range of millimeters to micrometers, so micrometer is 1/1000 of a millimeter. What we can see and resolve in a microscope, which is about 200 nanometers, so this is about 500 times better than a human being can resolve things. So in terms of size, however, this is still, compared to a normal molecule, a large spot that we are looking at, because a normal molecule is on average between, let's say, 1 to 10 nanometers. This means in light microscopy, we cannot resolve individual molecules, but only bunches of. In this green circle is essentially what we see, one light spot in a light microscope. Here in orange, this orange circle is about the size of a virus. The small white spot that you see in the very middle of this circle is essentially the size of an average molecule. If we compare this to the resolution limit that we have in light microscopy, which is this 200 nanometers, in this particular area, we would see rather in the range of about 5 to 10,000 individual molecules. Normal biological samples is merely a sack of water, so that doesn't give us a lot of contrast. So to look at individual molecules which the researchers are interested in, they have to indirectly stain them. For that, we're using fluorescent molecules.
So my name is Nick, and I work at the light microscopy facility at the Perutz as an imaging specialist. I mainly do on-demand trainings for users on our different systems, depending on experimental needs. Part of my job then is, of course, also routine maintenance of the different systems. The most important part probably is experimental planning with users. Users could have live cells where they want to image dynamic processes in those cells, and we have systems that can handle that easily. We also have systems that are more for dead cells, but where we can go really in depth in terms of resolution, so we can really create very highly resolved images. We can really focus on very, very small areas and really resolve those nicely. What sets me apart most in the team is image analysis. I have a background in molecular biology and bioinformatics, so I tend to gravitate towards the more data analysis side. The most beautiful part about light microscopy is also its largest, biggest problem, because what you get, what you acquire, are sometimes very, very beautiful or visually stunning images. But if you only look at an image, it might lead to conclusions. Whether they're wrong or right doesn't matter. But what you do need is to really make a claim or a statement about something that's happening in a cell, for example, is you need data, you need numbers. What I do then is I try to eliminate the visual aspect, yeah, which is sometimes hard, and then really regard the image data as numbers, as numerical data. It's really bringing an objectivity or removing any bias out of what you see, what you can see with the naked eye.
My name is Irmgard Fischer. On the one hand, I'm responsible for the in-house microscopes, and on the other hand, for the histology lab, starting at the in-house microscopes. So we provide for each floor a state-of-the-art wide-field system. I'm responsible there for maintenance, troubleshooting, on-demand trainings, also giving advice with the experimental setup, preparation of the samples. A special feature of that is that we have one software platform so that the people can barrier-free work with each microscope. What is also unique for in-house microscopes, we have color cameras, which are necessary for some applications, of course. So we try to cover many different requirements of the users. Coming back to the histology itself, so what we are doing here, we are equipped to make high-quality sections for paraffin or for cryo, as you need it. We even have a machine where you can cut out from section even areas of tissues and proceed for any other technique That's called laser microdissection. We are equipped with staining machine to make wonderful H&E sections. So what you see here is a hematoxylin eosin stained small brain section. So you see nuclei in blue and cytoplasm in shades of pink. One can say the histology lab is small but most versatile to meet as many requirements of our users as possible.